यस रेडी, प्लीज टेक दिस डिक्टेशन एट द रेट ऑफ 80 वर्ड्स पर मिनट। यू कैन प्रिपेयर फॉर योर SSC एग्जाम एज वेल बाय डूइंग दिस पैसेज। यस स्टार्ट। सर आई राइज टू सपोर्ट द डिमांड्स फॉर ग्रांट्स रिलेटिंग टू द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ लेबर बीइंग हेडेड बाय ए डायनामिक लीडर एंड यंग मिनिस्टर इन ए वास्ट कंट्री लाइक आवर्स वेयर वी हैव ए वेरी लार्ज पॉपुलेशन। लेबर फोर्स इज ए वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट इन्ग्रीडियंट फॉर द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ आवर नेशन। दिस पर्टिकुलर ह्यूमन रिसोर्स हैज़ नॉट बीन यूटिलाइज्ड टू द एक्सटेंट पॉसिबल। दिस इज इंडीड रिग्रेटेबल। वी शुड लुक अप ऑन पॉपुलेशन नॉट ओनली एज ए लाइबिलिटी बट इन द गिवन सर्कमस्टेंसेज आवर पॉपुलेशन और द मैन पावर शुड बी यूटिलाइज्ड टू द बेस्ट पॉसिबल एक्सटेंट बाय गिविंग सुटेबल ट्रेनिंग। आई थिंक द लेबर डिपार्टमेंट एंड द लेबरर्स डिजर्व ए ग्रेट डील ऑफ रिस्पेक्ट बिकॉज वॉट एवर वी डू इन दिस कंट्री द होल प्रोसेस ऑफ नेशनल रिकंस्ट्रक्शन रिवॉल्व्स अराउंड द वर्क ऑफ द लेबरर्स। अनफॉर्चुनेटली द लेबर फोर्स इज नॉट वेल ऑर्गेनाइज्ड। ओनली ए वेरी स्मॉल परसेंटेज ऑफ द लेबर फोर्स अबाउट 10% इज इन द ऑर्गेनाइज्ड सेक्टर। देयर इज अबाउट 90% ऑफ द लेबरर्स इन द अनऑर्गेनाइज्ड सेक्टर। फॉर द वेलफेयर ऑफ ए लार्ज नंबर ऑफ पीपल वेरियस लॉज आर बीइंग मेड। वी हैव बीन टॉकिंग अबाउट लेबर लेजिस्लेशन फॉर ए लॉन्ग टाइम। ए लॉट ऑफ लेजिस्लेशंस हैव ऑलरेडी बीन मेड बट वी हैव टू कंसिडर सीरियसली वेदर ऑल द लेजिस्लेशंस हैव हेल्प्ड द लेबर क्लास। आई एम सॉरी टू से दैट ए लॉट ऑफ दीज लॉज आर जस्ट accumulating dust and they have not been really useful in many circumstances unless the law is practiced in the proper spirit the workers will not be benefited. This particular aspect has to be taken into account while making the legislation. Now there have to be a great deal of political will and enthusiasm to see that the labor laws are really implemented and benefit the people. Para, our dynamic and young minister has recently said in a meeting in Pune that in this session a new legislation is going to be presented. It may not be completed in this session but certainly it is going to be introduced and it is for the benefit of the organized sector. A new comprehensive and integrated legislation is going to be introduced by the government for the sake of guaranteeing minimum wages and for providing pension for the people in the unorganized sector. The condition of the laborers is indeed very bad in our country. Look at any factory or any of the big public undertakings. How much care does the employer take for the benefit of the laborers on whose integrity and hard work the whole enterprise of that particular industry is flourishing? You will find that very few industrialists really look into the different welfare aspects of the laborers. Take the example of the families and the children of the laborers. Do their employers make proper arrangements for their health care and education? Leave aside their cultural upliftment or their cultural life. The families of the laborers are not looked after properly, and a great deal needs to be done. In this regard, voluntary organizations can play some role. A small amount has been provided for the welfare of children and women in the unorganized sector. I would urge upon the Honorable Minister that the allocations to the voluntary organizations for the betterment of women and children in the organized as well as unorganized sector should be increased. Para, sir, as regards the lockouts, wherever there is a lockout of the industry, the laborers have a great deal of suffering. They do not know what to do, and they are just left to their lot. But the employer does not suffer as such. Just look at the employers of different big industries. Their standard of living does not change after locking the industry, but the people in the factories are left on streets. I suggest that whenever the question of lockout in a particular industry comes up, the question should be considered whether the laborers will be able to run a particular industry, and a lot of considerations should be given to this particular aspect. And if possible, that particular industry should be kept alive. Sir, migration is a very important problem of labor, and it has got multi dimensions, that is, laborers within the country and those who are going outside the country. A lot of laborers are exported outside the country, and they are facing lot of problems because of agencies. I would like to mention here one thing, that we have entrusted this work to many of the private agencies, but there is need to consider whether we can have a manpower corporation and assign this work to the corporation. Also, there are problems of interstate migration of the laborers. There is an act, but it is causing difficulties to the laborers who migrate to other states. Stop and over.